Can you calculate the log of any number without using log table? You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. Before this process, let us take a look of some basics of log, and for that we should know what is logarithm. Logarithm is the inverse function of exponents, and log is its abbreviation, such as sine inverse x is inverse of sine x, root x is inverse of x square, and 1 minus x over x is inverse of 1 over 1 plus x. Actually, both the functions written on the left and right side are inverse of each other. When the variable inside the function is substituted by inverse function, then the result is that variable itself. For example, when x of sine x is substituted by sine inverse x, then the result is again x. Same cases are for all other functions until x belongs to the range of the function. Similarly, inverse of 10 to the power x is log x at the base 10, inverse of 2 to the power x is log x at the base 2, and that of a to the power x is log x at the base a. As previous, here also when x is substituted by log x with the corresponding base, the result is x. Inverse of any function is used when value of that function is given, and we have to find that for what value of variable in it this value of function is possible. In other words, we can say that if y is equal to sine x, then x is equal to sine inverse y. If y is square of x, then x is square root of y, and so on. Therefore, if y is equal to a to the power x, then x is equal to log y at the base a. Put the values of x and y from one into another, and we get two very basic properties of logarithm. Let's come to the topic: how to calculate the value of log without using log table. For this, we will use the series expansion of natural log 1 minus x and 1 plus x. Also, it is better to learn some simple values like log 2, log 3, and log e. We will explain all the steps by taking examples of log 29, log 547, and log 6723. First step is to multiply and divide the number inside log with any number such that its leftmost digit becomes 9 or 1, but use numbers whose log is known to you. In the first example, if we divide 29 by 3, then the value is 9.667. So we will divide and multiply 29 by 3. Using the properties of log, we can write log 9.667 times 3 equals to log 9.667 plus log 3. If we multiply 547 with 2, then the result is 1094. So we will divide and multiply by 2. In the next example, 6723 is a multiple of 3 whose value is known to us. Therefore, it is better to factorize it first and do the same thing. Now divide and multiply the number inside log by 10 to bring it near 1 so that we can apply the series expansion. 9.667 over 10 is equal to 0.9667, which is very near to 1. 1094 should be divided by 1000, and 10.375 should be divided by 10 to bring their values near to 1. Again, write them separately by using the properties of log. Since the expansion can be applied on natural log, therefore we have to rewrite these terms such that there is exponential coefficient e at their base. For this, we will use the identity log a at the base 10 equals to log a at the base e times log e at the base 10. Value of log e is 0.4349, hence log of 0.9667, 1.094, and 1.0375 can be written as 0.4349 times of log of 0.9667, 1.094, and 1.0375 respectively. Final step is using the series expansion of natural log 1 minus x and 1 plus x accordingly. First three terms of this series are sufficient to give the result accurate up to 4 decimal places, but if you want more accurate results, then the values which you have learned should also be learned up to more decimal places, and more terms of series expansion should be used. Finally, we get log 29, log 547 and log 6723 equals to 1.46241, 2.73799 and 3.82775, which are accurate up to 4 decimal places. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.